Are they going? Yes, we've got a kiss. We have a relationship. Romance is happening here in Founder's Fortune. Good morning, everyone. Dave from the Wee Hours here, back with some more Founder's Fortune, and our colony persists. We are praying for peace, but preparing for war. That's my philosophy right now. So we have constructed what is ostensibly known as the war room, which is where all the armor and weapons that everyone will need in the event of a fight will be stored. The theory being that they can all rush in, get all of their stuff at once, and be ready for battle, and not have to run around to each separate building to do it. We are also starting to build our wall. We've planned it out as far as we can with the amount of stone that we have. So at some point in time, people will get on constructing that, although there is a fair bit going on. Doris is very, very busy in the garden. It's the middle of summer. Doris has got a lot to do. Now, come here. Come here. You guys are having a chat. Do you Wait, who likes who now? Because it's gotten very soap opera in Founder's Fortune. Robert, do you like Henrietta? I don't remember. Yeah, you're pretty keen on Henrietta. So, Robert, is there anything you'd like to say to Henrietta? Oh, they've just had a bad conversation. Okay, maybe we'll just relax on Henrietta for the moment. Let's have Henrietta apologize to Robert for whatever terrible, terrible thing just happened between them, because Robert's having a super bad day, and now Henrietta's gonna wake Robert up to apologize. Hopefully this will go over fairly well. Yeah, they generally like the apologize prompt. They're very keen on that. Very polite in Founder's Fortune. They apologize for something and everyone moves on with their lives, and Henrietta's just gonna hang out over by the fire. Okay, fair enough. Henrietta, when you're warmed up, I guess. It is the middle of summer, but I don't know why you need to warm up. Get some more stone, because I really want to get moving on the whole wall around the compound thing. Well, bright and early the next morning, I want to see if Henrietta can give Robert a hug. If Robert might be interested in a hug. Yeah, they're pretty okay with that. There's the butt touching, all about the butts in this game. Yeah, they're pretty chill with that. Now, what do we have to do? Locked for 47 seconds to get to the higher level. I want to keep pushing this along. I want to really figure out how relationships work in this game because these guys ain't getting any younger. Henrietta, I believe, is our youngest colonist, and she's going to age up in 54 days. That's not no time. Days go by pretty quickly in Founder's Fortune. Doris, you must have nothing to do in the garden because you are out building the wall. Good. I like a good wall. That's going to keep some people out. We are basically friendly with the people surrounding us and our neighbors, except one of them that will kill us on sight. So let's make sure we're proceeding in that direction of keeping them away from us. Speaking of our neighbors, they're back. The humble people want cotton and wood. That is actually fine. We can easily replenish that. In fact, we're a little overstocked on wood. So yeah, that is absolutely no problem. They love us right now. They absolutely love us. I would like to get, speaking of our neighbors, which makes me think about trade, I would like to get the storage shelf for the scrolls, the research scrolls, kicking along. But we need iron ore for that, and Henrietta is not a good enough miner to do that. How far away from you are that? Oh, sorry, right, I've got you on craftsman right now. You can actually go back to being a miner. Sorry, I forgot I briefly changed you. I told you that was only temporary. So yeah, and you're about halfway there. You're about halfway to being a better miner, and at that point we could mine iron ore rather. In the meantime, I might peel Bernard off of wood, because we're well stocked. We've got plenty of wood, and we've got some swords queued up here that we've never gotten around to making. You know what, Bernard? Take a break. Why don't you go make some tools? Get some swords ready. I'd like to have some things in here for people to, stab people with. And we've actually got enough cotton too. Oh, we have one of these queued up. All right, I did queue up another piece of armor there. That's fine. That can sit there. Bernard, maybe when you're done with that, we'll have you do that. In fact, now that I've said all of that out loud, Bernard, why don't you spin off to being a craftsman temporarily? You may as well. Just go ahead and make some swords and make some armor, and maybe we can get you up a level in craftsman while we don't really need the wood right now. and Robert's feeling better about life right now. Someone in the comments had said the talk about food prompt pretty much always goes over well. That's a very neutral thing to talk about, which indeed it is. And none of the colonists seem to have a problem talking about food. Certainly they're eating enough of it, and I want to come back to that too, look at rewards points and get some negative traits out of here. How are you feeling about talking about food, Henrietta and or Robert, whomever would like to chime in on that? You seem basically okay with it. Yeah, relationship friend. Okay, cool. How long till the next one? 597 seconds. I can't do math that well. Right, I'll just check in on that later. Let's take a chance on a hug as well. Maybe we can get this really, really boosted up and get close to the next level. Oh, I think that was a hug. It was a terrible hug because I think we had a little bit of a pathing issue there. Hold the phone, Robert. Why don't you... Oh, that risky joke. Actually, you know what? Forget the relationship thing. Why don't you try splinting her arm? She's had a broken arm for ages. Really sorry, Henrietta. Very, very sorry about that. Oh, this is, That's an intimate way to... Okay, you know what? I'm just gonna look away. I think the relationship is proceeding faster than I expected it to. And the butt warming continues because it's all about butts in this game. Henrietta, do you have basically nothing to be doing right now? You're enjoying the fire. Okay, we do kind of need to get some more stone back in play. Can't work because of your broken arm. That's fussy. Okay, did the splinting not go over well then? How's your health? Wow, you're going to be out of action on that for a really long time, Henrietta. A really, really long time. Wait, Robert, what's your problem? Oh, you're starving. Well, don't let me stop you from getting some food, man. Just eat food. It's cool. Robert, I know you're fast asleep, but can you try splinting the arm again, please? Because I've got to get Henrietta back up and running. We really just can't be down a colonist for what will amount to game day. Whatever you're doing, Robert, whatever you're doing, this is not splinting. Arm splint successful, despite the animation. That was not splinting an arm, man. I think it's getting a little late night in Founder's Fortune. Okay, Henrietta, does that make you feel better about things? Arm is stabilized. It will heal in a short while. I would assume that means the time to heal is going to go down. That would be my guess anyway. And while we're here, why don't we talk about food with Henrietta? Because you guys really like talking about food, and it's probably not going to cause you to insult somebody or lose relationship points. So chit-chat about, well, basically tomatoes. That's what we often eat. In fact, you, I believe, are talking about tomatoes. Are you talking about a specific food? No, you're talking about food in general. That might be a tomato. It might be an apple. One way or another, we probably have both on stock right now. So have fun with that, kids. Yeah, we are definitely getting somewhere with these two. You're going to both have a snack. That's fine. You did talk about food. It probably made you real, real hungry. Maybe after that, you might like to hug each other. I don't know. We may give it a shot. Yeah, Henrietta and Robert and his fabulous mustache, version 2.0, not real sad about the hugging. They're liking the hugging. How are we doing, guys? Yeah, you're like halfway to the next thing, and that will unlock in 200 some odd seconds. What do you guys have to do? Robert, we're actually great on crystals right now. We have no need for crystals. Why don't you analyze them instead? Henrietta, you're back to work. Great. Don't need crystals. Get some stone instead, please. Bernard, did you finish anything? You've been over there for a long time. I'm sorry, Bernard. I often don't check in on you. I apologize for that. Wait, why do you not have a weapon stand? Does everyone else have a weapon stand? You have one. You have one. You have one. You don't have one. Which one was unoccupied? Okay, the one all the way at the end here. So take ownership of that, please. Okay, now you have an armor and a weapon stand. Did you make anything? Yeah. Ooh, when did we get a wooden axe? I must have made one of those. Anyway, have a wooden sword right there, and that can be your wooden sword. Now, do you also have an armor thing? Yes, you do. Okay. So everyone else, do we get more swords made? Yes. And then what's left? I think one wooden sword. You may as well queue up another one. That's fine. And then we'll probably move on to the armor. And Robert gets a sword. There we go. Everyone's getting a weapon. Don't want to fight anyone, but ready to do it if we have to. That's the goal. I'm gonna give these guys a break and have Henrietta go down and talk about food again. That seems to be a good introduction to a hug. Talk about food and then hug about food, I guess. But yeah, talk about some things, then we'll try another hug. We are unlocked to the next level. We can proceed to Great Friend, which I actually think is somebody's wish, if I'm not mistaken. What do you want? You want the large bookshelf in your house. Oh, hang on. I can make that happen right now. Which one is your house? That one over there? Can do. I'm going to very briefly give Robert some money because he would like that. It's his other wish. I want to get the level 3 scholar thing done, but that's just going to happen through time. So we'll knock this out of the box. Robert's the one I want to focus on for rewards points because we got to get this pessimist thing out of here. It's a permanent -7 debuff to his mood, and that ain't nothing. That's not nothing at all. We're hoping you have a lot of good dreams to make up for that. So tomorrow we'll back that off. Oh, hi. Hello. We have a new colonist. Okay. What do you do? You kind of look like Doris version 2.0. What's your deal? Hi. Well, you know what? Just forget it. I'm taking you anyway. So, accept the migrant. There we go. Off you go, Henrietta. Go accept our new friend, and then we'll learn about our new friend. Oh, this is very exciting. We have a new colonist. I was kind of thinking it was about time. Well, welcome to the team, Mia. Welcome. What's your deal? First off, you want a mason's workshop and a place to store armor. We're definitely going to work on that. You don't worry about that, Mia. What could we know about you? You like fruit salad, you're a killer, and you have bad health. Fine. Get rid of the bad health. I can probably live with the other two. Well, we can get started right away with an armor thing. Let me just nip over to the war room, Mia. You'll get used to this place over time, but we're gonna put some stuff down for you. So I'll have Mia get straight to work building her own armor stand, and then we need to plot out a house for you. And that means we're gonna need a whole lot more wood. Bernard, where are you? Oh, you're building the wall. Oh, okay. Yeah, good move. Good move, man. Why don't you go back to being a cutting down tree guy, forester. Thank you. Go back to doing that, please, because we kind of need that sooner rather than later. We're going to need a lot of wood for this. Okay, Mia, come here. This belongs to you now. And there's a wish fulfilled right there. And this one belongs to you, too. What do you got on the board for me now? You want a research scroll stand. Can't do it. Don't got iron ore. All right, Mason's workbench. We might be able to work on that. Do we actually know how to make that? Yeah, we totally do. Okay, it's only 35 stone and 20 wood. Mia, you ask, you receive. That can go right here in the workshop area. Oh dear, we got bugs. We got bugs. Doris is fast asleep. Ooh, we have not a small amount of bugs either. Mia, I need you to take a break from that and yeah, get all the infested plants out of here. No need to become a farmer. Doris has got that under control. I say under control. We're out of tomato season, I think. And we've only got the potatoes left. Don't want to put down a few more potatoes. I'm not going to say no to it. May as well have a little bit more kicking around. Well, Mia is all tuckered out after her first day in the colony and has decided to fall asleep in the dirt with the bugs, and Doris is just going to work around that. That's fair. Doris is kind of a pro at these things. This is not unusual for her at all. Mia, you're going to be expected to work a lot harder in this colony than you are right now. Bernard is working on chopping down some trees for you so you can build your own house. That's pretty much how we do things around here. When you get up, I'd like you to do literally anything rather than just hanging around. Now, I'm just going to begin construction. Yeah, Mia's right in. Mia's getting the hint here. Come over and build your own house. Floor might be one of the last things to go in, Mia, because Bernard is frantically chopping down trees to make all of this happen. So appreciate that. Maybe you and Bernard could have a thing. Who knows? But let's get some basics under control here, like a bed, because you're going to be really keen on that. We do not have the 25 wood yet. Bernard, I need you to kind of stay on task, if you could, please, with cutting the trees down. Thank you. And Robert, just take a quick break from research, if you could, please. Oh, I was going to have you gather the apples, which indeed you are, but Doris is over here too. That's fine. Let's just get them down. We'll hopefully get at least one more crop in before winter hits. Food is okay. I would like it if it was better, but I'm willing to live with what it is right now. Did you get enough wood to do the bed? I believe you did. So let's get Mia a bed, one of the nicer beds, if we can. Perfect. Mia, that's all you, or at least it will be when you claim ownership of it. So Mia, that is now your bed. That should fulfill some things. Wait, you hated that. Oh, you're envious of Henrietta's room. Yeah, and you really do want a floor. Okay, you just got here, Mia. You're very demanding. You just showed up. Everyone else built this colony, not you. Okay, well, let's see what we can do with the floor. It's not going to be a nice floor. I want to be clear about that. Actually, this is a pretty nice floor, all things considered. But it, in my mind, it's not a very nice floor, Mia. Well, that takes off Mia's little debuff about having no floor in her room. Let's see what else we can do to make her happy. You could probably get... Well, let's get you started right. Let's get you a storage area for your tools that you will eventually use because you will be productive around here. I will give you... Yeah, it's iron ore for the higher level ones. What about that one? That's also iron ore. Okay, you can't have a very nice flower pot, but you can have a flower pot. Does that help you? Yes, it actually is. You're not jealous anymore. And the slept on the ground thing will go away because you're not sleeping on the ground anymore. All right, I think we can get Mia back up and running here. A little bit of a hesitant start with you, but... Oh, you want a chair probably, don't you? What are your wishes? I'm sorry. You want the research scroll stand? Okay, we need iron ore for that. And you want to get a job? I would like you to get a job too, if we're all honest about things. What would be the best job for you? First of all, I should figure out what you do for a living. Yeah, you have a skill in forestry. That's about it. That's good. That's handy. There's nothing wrong with that. I'm going to put you into craftsman for the moment. If only because if I do make you a forester, I should get you an axe. Oh, wait, we have a spare axe. We have a spare axe. I could put you over to forester right now. We have an axe. Yeah, I could put this axe right here. Oh, we've got a sword that's opened up too. Somebody must have finished one of those. Put that axe in there. That's fine. But I'm going to put you onto craftsman so we can start making some stuff to sell. That would be a pretty smart thing to do. What can I do in the mason's workshop? Stone axe and a stone pickaxe. Ooh, that's probably way better than what we've got right now. And a little bit more stone. Well, a lot more stone because I give them the stone axe and they're going to need... Okay, make one of those. Long story short, Mia. I got these two crazy kids over here talking about food again, because that's fun. There we go. Oh, you're a great friend now. Okay, hold the phone. Hold that thought, guys. Hold that thought. What do we take to get to the next level of that? Oh, we can just move right in. Right. Well, start the hugging then. Let's get some hugging under control here. Oh, we can kiss. Okay, start with the hug. Start with the hug. And let's see what we can do after that. Are they going? Yes, we've got a kiss. We have a relationship. Romance is happening here in Founder's Fortune. Oh, yeah. It's the mustache, isn't it? It's the fabulous mustache. Who could turn it down, frankly? Who wouldn't want to kiss that? All right, kids. You know what? You do you at this point. You just go off and do whatever you want. I'm sure you're just giddy and walking on air after kissing Robert's fabulous mustache. Now we got a trader who just showed up. Sure. I mean, we'll take a look at it. Go see if he's got anything good. Don't really think we have anything to trade. Don't have much kicking around. That reminds me, I should line up some of those watering cans. Those are just a license to print coins. Oh, that also reminds me to turn off Robert's payday. What have you got, Sparky? Not a lot. And there's nothing I want to sell. I don't really have enough wood or stone to be selling. I mean, I can get it back fairly quickly, but we're using it right now. You have some strawberries. That's nice. No, I think we're good. I think we're good. All right. Robert, back it off. Back it off. You don't get paid anymore. What do you want now, by the way? Get a dresser in your house. Okay, we could do that. I'm not 100% sure we got enough wood for that, but I bet we can do that. I actually just want to move this. Ooh, where do I want to move this? Anywhere at all. I would guess it probably doesn't matter which dresser Robert gets, so long as he gets a dresser. So that'll be a nice, easy one to tick off. Wait, what's Henrietta's problem? Why is Henrietta having an issue? What's your deal? All right, well, whatever your issue is, it went away. You want a big shelf or wardrobe in your house. Okay, I guess we're starting to decorate now. Big shelf or wardrobe can do. Ooh, the children of the forest want tomatoes. I don't have unlimited food, children of the forest. But I think if we don't pay their shakedown fee, we're going to go into negative and they might attack us. I'm going to have to go ahead and do that for right now. You also took away the thing I was building. Thanks, children of the forest. Appreciate that one. Mia did finish the stone axe, so I'm going to give that to Bernard because, you know, he's chopping trees down. It looks like you're probably going to swing right over there and grab that, change that out. You are still working on what exactly? Oh, brewery. Right. Yeah, I've been working on that for ages. I now have concerns about the food because, you know, we just gave away a bunch of it. Let's get some more potatoes. It's pretty much the only other thing we can grow at this point. Lined up in here, please. I think we'll probably be okay, but I did not want to give up all of that food. That was not a good move. Now, Henrietta, peel back, please. We are fine on crystals right now. Really just focus on the stone, if you could. I do appreciate your initiative, but you see we are maxed out on crystals, and we have virtually no stone left, so I would love it if you actually got back to work on that. Hey, Doris, what are you up to? You're doing things in the garden. Oh, you're cooking food. Okay, that's a perfectly valid thing for you to be doing. Robert, I know you're just researching, so could you just go grab these healing plants for no reason other than they exist? I mean, we may as well have them. Maybe if we get shaken down again, they might ask for that instead of food. Yeah, Mia is being back to jealous of Henrietta's room. I did to give Henrietta that wardrobe. How would you like a wardrobe? Would you like a wardrobe? Long story short, I'm going to give you a wardrobe and hope that that will cheer you up a little. It can live right over here. You've got a flower pot. What else is in decoration that you might like? Nothing really, because we haven't unlocked much. I could give you some windows, and then you could have a window box. Yeah, so let's start from fundamentals here. Why don't we give you a window? Nobody else in the colony has a window, Mia. All right, nobody. So, you know, enjoy this. Well, Mia finished the armor, so weirdly, I'm just going to go ahead and give that to her, because why not? It's right there. Did we make another wooden sword? Dang, I had a lot of those queued up. Sure, put that one there then. That's fine, that's hers. You are ready to go when battle happens. Maybe you might be more military inclined, Mia. Maybe we'll save up some rewards points and give you killer or something like that. So, back to decoration. Have shutters, because those don't cost very much. And have a window box, too. You better be really happy with your house at this point. Yeah, that nipped that in the bud. She's not jealous of Henrietta's house anymore. Speaking of Henrietta and Robert, you crazy kids, you crazy young lovebirds. Where's Robert? Oh, Robert's over here mining crystals, which is kind of useless. Let's go hug Robert, and then we might kiss Robert again. And his fabulous mustache. Version 2.0. Awkward kiss there, Robert. Awkward kiss, but good effort, good effort. Henrietta seems to be broadly into it. Yep, you guys are just fine with that. What's your relationship at right now? Yeah, your lovers. Cool. The consensus in the comments, in terms of how do we get kids in this place? Because, you know, there's biology that needs to happen. Is apparently, you want to put two beds in the same room. So two beds in the same room should do the trick. I just don't know when we can do that. So let me know in the comments, can I move Robert into Henrietta's room now or vice versa? Or do I need to wait until they're a higher level? I do see love of her life is the next highest level. Maybe that would be the point to move in together. We'll see. But anyway, we'll call it here on Founder's Fortune for today. Do please keep me posted in the comments of any ideas or tips or thoughts that you might have about our budding colony here. And we'll pick up some more of this again next time. Hey, if you enjoyed the video, do please leave a like down below. It does cheer me up no end when people do that. If you're new to the channel, maybe just checking it out for the first time, feel free to hit that subscribe button. See more of this ridiculous nonsense. Until then, I'm Dave. Thank you, as always, for joining me in the wee hours, and we'll see you next time. Robot, how do we rescue you? I don't know how to rescue you. I'm also not sure I ever knew you were a woman. Bugs are inherently stupid, and they get in places and they can't get out. You know what places they get in? Things that are wide open that don't have screens over them. It's a piece of mesh. We figured this out like 100 years ago. What is wrong with the British, the Irish?
Is it just a show about foxes all the time? If so, is that some sort of subtle esoteric thing about being a weapons manufacturer, or is it just stuck on the Nature Channel?